Rakesh from Let's Make Learning Simple channel. Now we are going to discuss about object pool design pattern in theoretical way using some real-time examples and using some Java-oriented implementations in a detailed manner. In the next video, we will discuss about object pool design pattern using some sample code. So we will try to implement the object design pattern using some real-time example scenario. So first, what is object pool? So actually, pool is a collection of something. If we consider swimming pool, it's a collection of water where n number of people can swim at a particular time. Similarly, object pool is a collection of objects. So n number of clients can be served by that object pool at a particular moment. So first, object pool design pattern falls under creational design pattern. The reason behind that is this design patterns, it comes under the stage that during the object creation stage. That's the reason why it falls under creational design pattern. See, this pattern falls only at the object creation time. And the second point is reuse the objects that are expensive to create. So this statement would be explained using this real-time example and the Java-oriented real-time example. So this is a real life example. If you are doing engineering means, then you would have to write exams for the 8 semester. So nearly 8 semesters. So for each semester, there would be n number of papers. So for writing the exam, you would try to study n number of books for one particular paper. Some people would find it difficult to buy those books because the books are very expensive. At that time, what they would do is they will try to get the books from the library. So if I am that person, I will try to get the books that require books from the library. So after that semester, I will try to return those books to the library. So here I am trying to get the books from library. So library is serving us. After finishing our job, we will try to return those books to the library. Then library uses those books to serve other people. So here the books are the objects. The books are getting reused. So instead of buying the books, we are trying to get books from the library. After finishing our purpose, our job, we are trying to return those books. So that the library representative will reuse those books and that library representative will serve many people. So that's the real life example where object pool design pattern is implemented. And the real time example where object pool design pattern is useful in Java. If there are n number of clients, now nearly 1000 clients. 1000 clients are trying to create a database connection pool. So if you create one database connection pool itself, it's a very expensive object because it involves n number of resources. If suppose 1000 clients are creating this similar kind of object, means then the expensive would be 1000x. So instead of that, what we'll try to do is we'll try to reuse the object that were already created by someone. That's the person is called reusable pool. This reusable pool, what it do is it will try to create some object, some limited object. It will try to manage the clients. For example, if suppose 4 clients are asking the objects, means this reusable pool size, this reusable pool will try to serve those 4 clients. This reusable object pool will act as a manager for the objects. So it will try to get the used objects from the clients, and it will try to give those objects to the clients who are aspirant to get those objects. That's the power of this reusable pool. So these are the advantages when we use this object pool design pattern in our code. The first advantage would be boost the performance. So since the object creation is a costly operation, in some cases when you consider database connection pool, it's a very costly operation. Since we are reusing these objects, we are trying to improve the performance, so it will boost the performance automatically. And then it saves the memory. For example, if suppose n number of clients are using n number of objects, means that n number of objects would occupy some memory. Since we are using the objects, that it would implicitly save some memory. And then it reuses the objects, it saves resources also. Because to create an object, it needs some n number of resources. Since we are reusing these objects, we are trying to we are trying to save the resources for some other purposes. That's the, these are the advantages. There are other advantages are also applicable for this object design, object pool design pattern. We'll try to cover those things in the upcoming video when we try to implement the actual, when we try to implement the object pool design pattern using some real time, using some real case scenario. So at that time you will see in depth about this object pool design pattern. For now, just get this idea theoretically. Please, we will try to implement this theoretical ideas in the practical way in the upcoming video. Thanks once again. Please try to subscribe my channel for watching this kind of